tell our story, Lord, out of mind tonight. And I just know there never will be. It's a beautiful life. A beautiful life. Up in the morning, underneath the shade of an oak tree, colors on the leaves are changing, seasons moving endlessly. Man, where did the time go? We got some history. A little bit older now, but you still look so good to me. One thing I know, you are my soul. Got a life ahead of us.
For the repose of the soul of Dahlia Tiziana Rota, and a special intention. Kindly switch off your cell phones or turn them to silent. Today's readings revolve around healing and belief. Jesus risks touching a diseased man in order to heal him, while Paul talks about challenges of conscience in a world of differing beliefs. The invitation here is to be open to the call to trust that God is at work amid our fear of difference and otherness and our fear of the darkness within ourselves. Please stand for the entrance hymn.
God forgave my sin in Jesus' name. I've been born again in Jesus' name, and in Jesus' name I come to you to share His love as He told me to. He said, freely, freely you have received.
And of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to our celebration of the Eucharist tonight. Let's just take a moment to prepare ourselves for this sacrament, as we take a moment to acknowledge our sins and our failings, and then we ask the Lord for mercy. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let's pray. O God, you teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true. Grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Word of God's being, you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know that you're in this place. Please let me stay and rest in your holiness. Word of God.
The third book of the Bible, Leviticus, is a collection of Jewish laws. Old Testament people believed that being clean or unclean, that is, kosher or non-kosher, was based on what was considered to be normal or abnormal. For example, Because a snake slithered on the ground rather than walked, it was considered abnormal and therefore unclean. By the same standards, people with disabilities or deformities were seen as unclean. We see a particular case addressed in this reading.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, "When a person has on the skin of his body a swelling or an eruption or a spot, and it turns into leprous disease on the skin of his body, then he shall be brought to Aaron the priest, or to one of his sons the priest. He is a leprous man, he is unclean. The priest must pronounce him unclean. His disease is on his head. The leper has the disease, shall wear torn clothes, and let the hair of his head hang loose, and he shall cover his upper lip and cry, 'Unclean, unclean.' He shall remain unclean as long as he has the disease. He is unclean. He shall dwell alone in a habitation outside the camp." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray the responsorial psalm, beginning and ending with the response. You are a hiding place for me. You surround me with cries of deliverance. Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is remitted. Bless the man to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, in whose spirit is no guile. To you I have acknowledged my sin, my guilt I did not hide. I said, "I will confess my transgressions to the Lord," and you have forgiven the guilt of my sin. Rejoice in the Lord, exult you just, ring out your joy, all you upright of heart. You are a hiding place for me. You surround me with cries of deliverance.
Today's passage concludes a long section of 1 Corinthians, in which Paul has been addressing disputes between Jewish Christians and Gentile Christians about what foods are kosher. Paul now makes a general observation that while we may, in principle, be free to do this or that, we should avoid those things that disrupt harmony and peace.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whether you eat or drink, or whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. Give no offense to Jews or to Greeks or to the Church of God, just as I try to please all people in everything I do, not seeking my own advantage, but that of many, that they may be saved. Be imitators of me, as I am of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation. Prophet has arisen among us, and God has visited his people.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, a leper came to Jesus, begging him, and kneeling, said to him, "If you will, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hand and touched him, and said to him, "I will, be clean." And immediately the leprosy left him, and he was made clean. And he sternly charged him and sent him away at once and said to him, "See that you say nothing to anyone, but go, show yourself to the priest, and offer for your cleansing what Moses commanded, for a proof to the people." But he went out and began to talk freely about it, and to spread the news, so that Jesus could no longer openly enter a town, but was out in the country. And people came to him from every quarter. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So that poor leper had two sufferings to carry. Not only was he suffering from illness, but he was also cut off from the community. Lepers had to live outside the village or town in a sort of a leper colony because they believed of the contagious nature of the disease. The leper is unclean. He shall dwell alone in a habitation outside the camp. In the first reading from the book of Leviticus, we hear the rules concerning lepers. When people were nearby lepers, lepers were to say, "Unclean, unclean," and the leper shouldn't even have been in the village that day when Jesus came. And even when he approached Jesus, the leper kept his distance. Jesus had to stretch out his hand to touch him when curing him. And when Jesus healed the leper, Jesus not only healed his illness, but restored him to his community and family once again. We just think about what the lepers suffered down through the centuries of being isolated like that. And today we are still experiencing the painful isolation of people trying to stay safe during the COVID-19 pandemic. By February this year, COVID-19 had infected about 100 million people worldwide, with over 60 million recovering, a lot more recovering, and about 2 million deaths. This is right around the world. And through the centuries, humankind has been beset by many illnesses, some of which have altered the course of history. For example, in the 14th century, the Black Death or the bubonic plague swept through Asia and Europe. By the year 1350, about half of the population of Europe had died from the bubonic plague. In more recent times, in 1918, there was the epidemic of influenza. It lasted from February 1918 to April 1920. It infected about 500 million people. That's about a third of the world's population in four successive waves. The death toll is estimated to be somewhere between 20 million and 50 million people. So those have been huge disasters for humankind in the past. And during an epidemic, one of the first reactions is to quarantine the sick so as to protect the healthy, and separated from the rest of society, those held in quarantine suffered doubly, first from the illness and its terrors, and then from the isolation. In the ancient world, victims of leprosy knew all too well this double dose of suffering. We are meant for community. We are not meant for isolation. Whenever we celebrate the Eucharist, we are celebrating as a community, and in community we make Christ real. And love is always the characteristic of the Christian community. As Paul said to the Corinthians, if I give away everything but I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Jesus also said, by this will all know that you are my disciples, if you have love one for another. And that's why Paul could say in our second reading today, be imitators of me as I am of Christ. In other words, take me for your model as I take Christ for my model. And so everyone in the community is to reflect Christ. So we've been created for community. We're called to live our faith in and with a community. And the one effect of the coronavirus pandemic has been that we can't gather in church for Mass as we used to. And as we all know, at the moment, we only allowed 50 people to gather inside our church for a service. And so that means that we will need to observe Ash Wednesday next week in a new way. So this year, in 2021, we will have Ash Wednesday at home. Mass will be live streamed on Ash Wednesday in the morning of the 17th of February, as we do every day. And then, this is what I ask. I ask that you visit the church, collect the blessed ashes, and take them home. The ashes will be in a little envelope, be attached to a leaflet with a prayer service. And so, at home, gather your family, and in the prayer service, the leader of the service can sprinkle the blessed ashes on top of the heads of all present. And so that will be Ash Wednesday at home. That's the best way that we can connect to each other in faith in the midst of the pandemic. It is challenging to live our faith in and with the community in this time. And it's easy to feel isolated and disconnected from our parish during a time when just 50 people are permitted to gather in the church. So this year, in 2021, I encourage you, as we begin the season of Lent next week on Wednesday, that we can make a special effort to connect as community in new ways. On our parish website, we have about 1,400 subscribers, and we have over 500 people each week reading the newsletter which appears every Friday morning by email in your inbox. And so, if you're not subscribed, if you're not getting our newsletter, please do so during Lent. Also, if you know of a Catholic who feels isolated and disconnected, make an effort during Lent to reach out. And so, I want to encourage us all to make Lent 2021 a time of connecting and reaching out to family, reaching out to all in our parish community. It's so important that we can connect in a meaningful way. Here is an example. So Mary sends a WhatsApp to me. It's a Bible verse and it reads, whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. 1 Corinthians 10:31. Now, it comes as an image with a pretty border, background picture. It's written in a fancy font. And I just delete it because it's got no connection to me. There are many of these memes and things like that. Look pretty, floating on the web, but it's basically anonymous. It's like spam. Then Miriam sends me a WhatsApp. It says, dear Keith, I read, whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. In 1 Corinthians 10, verse 31. And it touched me. I had a bit of self-pity in my isolation, but realized that despite my isolation, I can live for the glory of God. I read that WhatsApp. You see how different it is. Miriam has shared of herself, and I've listened to Miriam. And in this way, I'm connected to Miriam. And I'm humbled by her sharing and her trust. It's not reading spam. This is connecting to a real person. Jesus stretched out his hand and touched a leper. And just as Jesus connected to that leper, so Miriam connects to me in that message, and I'm all the better for it. When reading scripture, I always like to look at the readings of the day from the Missal, because each day has a focus. It can be meaningful for some to read random verses of scripture, but I much prefer the readings of the day. If I look at the weekday readings of the day for 2 years, I will be reading all the significant passages from the Bible. If I look at the Sunday readings over a period of 3 years, I'll be reading all the significant passages from the Bible. And so it's not just little bits what I like. I get a comprehensive overview in doing that. You see, the liturgical year and spiritual life coincide. This is a certainty, because the goal of spiritual life is to let oneself be increasingly open to the God of all creation. And the liturgy is the most important way of helping us in this. We are created so that we can become ourselves completely when, and only when, we let ourselves be open to God, both explicitly or implicitly. We love, and we are loved insofar as this takes place, whether we know it or not. And Jesus lived among us as a human being in time and space, and the liturgy gradually exposes us to that. When we live the seasons of Advent and Christmas and Lent and Easter and ordinary time, we are living the life of Jesus, and we are encountering his presence among us. And so these 4 points just describe the spiritual life, which allows us to encounter God and discover our meaning and purpose in life. And so as Jesus healed the leper and restored him to community, we are reminded that we have been created for community. We are called to live our faith in and with a community. And so this Lent 2021, I call on us all to connect as a parish community. Let's stand, and we now express our faith together as we say the Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In a spirit of mercy and compassion, we bring before God the needs of our suffering world.
We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that he may continue to lead us in building a church of openness and compassion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the leaders of South Africa, that their policies may be for the common good, remembering especially the needs of those who are poorest and most vulnerable. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the grace to imitate Christ, that God will help us to love others, confront lies and injustice, and surrender ourselves in service to God and neighbor, as did Jesus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all who are ill, that God will touch the sick and return them to wholeness, free the human family from the coronavirus, and spread the distribution of the vaccines. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all married couples, that God will continue to deepen their love and help their relationship give witness to God's loving presence in the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for deceased members of our families and friends whose anniversaries occur about this time, especially for Dalia Tiziana Rota. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for Justin Luenga, Colette Caldwell, Dave Clevin, and Father Ronnie Carnes, who died during the week. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine on them. May they rest in peace. Amen.
Let us pray for strength during the pandemic. God of love, we turn to you with prayerful hearts and with confidence in your loving presence among us. We stand before you as a people of hope, trusting in your care and protection. May we be comforted by your love in these anxious times. Generous and merciful God, fill us with compassion and concern for others, young and old, that we may look after each other in these challenging times, especially those among us who are vulnerable. Heal us of our fear. Healing God, bring healing to those who are sick with the coronavirus, and be with their families and neighbors. We pray especially for those who are isolated, that they may know your love. Stay by our side in this time of uncertainty and sorrow. God of strength, accompany all those who serve us with such love and generosity in the medical profession and in all our health care facilities. We give thanks for their continued work in the service of people. We ask you to bless them, strengthen them, and guide them with your abundant goodness. God of wisdom, we ask you to guide the leaders in healthcare and governance, that the rollout of the vaccines may be swift and reach all our people. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thanks with a grateful heart, give thanks to the Holy One, give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ His Son, and now let the weak the Holy One, give thanks, because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son, give thanks, give thanks, give thanks.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His church.
May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'll use the Eucharistic prayer of various needs, number 3. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Lord. For by your word you created the world, and you govern all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your words to us, and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son you gather men and women, whom you made for the glory of your name, into one family, redeemed by the blood of his cross, and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore now and for ages unending with all the angels, we proclaim your glory, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy and to be glorified, O God. You love the human race. You always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis our Pope, Bhuti and Duncan our bishops, with all other bishops, priests and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you, through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Masiti amen, siakudu besa. Masiti amen, bawo. Amen, bawo. Amen, siaku dumesa.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, thy name, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done upon the earth. give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive. Forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours now and forever, amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us pause for a moment as we sing our peace song, as we pray for peace in our hearts and peace in the world.
We are many, we are one body, we are one body in Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, we are one body in Christ. Of God, O Jesus Christ, take away our sins and have mercy on us all, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, O Jesus Christ, take away our sins.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Dear friends, I now invite all who are watching on our YouTube channel to make your own personal act of spiritual communion at this moment. My Jesus, I believe you are really here in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you more than anything in the world and I hunger to receive you. But since I cannot receive communion at this moment, feed my soul spiritually, I unite myself to you now, as I do when I receive you. Amen.
Strength like no other.
Let us pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Would you please be seated for a few moments? I'd just like to let everyone know that our parish library, which is at the hall, is open again. It's open on the first and third Sundays after at 8:30 in the morning, on Sunday mornings, also on Wednesdays after Mass. So we encourage that as we approach the Lent and we make our Lenten resolutions to read a book this Lent, because the library's got a great selection of books on spirituality, Bible studies, saints, and so on. Material is, these are the Live Lent booklets I was mentioning from Renew, and so these are available in the repository and during the week available in the parish office. And it's great for even a person on their own or a small faith sharing group for meditation right through the 40 days of Lent. So I mentioned Ash Wednesday earlier, and just to remind you that Ash Wednesday is coming up on Wednesday, the 17th of February. It's a day of fast and abstinence. Fast meaning we're fasting from food as much as we can, and abstinence means abstaining from eating meat. As I said on Ash Wednesday, this year the focus, because of the pandemic, because we can't have more than 50 people in the church, the focus on Ash Wednesday will be Ash Wednesday at home, and this is what the little leaflet looks like, and this contains blessed ashes, this little brown envelope there. And so I'll be encouraging you to take one per family, to take it home, and in prayer service at home, follow the prayer service in the leaflet, and you'll come to a time when ashes will be sprinkled. Now, this year, we won't be marking the ashes on your forehead like this as it usually is. The ashes will be sprinkled on top of your head so that there's no contact. And this is happening in every Catholic parish throughout the entire world. This is the instruction that we have, just to make sure there's no physical contact which could pass on the coronavirus. And that's why we're doing it like that. So this is for Ash Wednesday at home. We've got two things else happening. We've got Mass will be live streamed. Again, with such a small number, I think it's pretty much fully booked already. And also at 6 o'clock, we're going to have a special family Ash Wednesday in lockdown service. It will be on Zoom, so you can go see in the parish newsletter, or you can go on the website where you can get the Zoom link, the password and those kind of things on. And so it will work like this. It will be done in the form, well, where there'll be some families leading the service, and then people can join in via Zoom. That'll be on Wednesday at 6 p.m. Again, we're doing this just so that people can be at home and stay safe. Right, what else? Yes, just a reminder, we've got the bulletins printed. They're in the foyer of the church. And just a reminder that these are a one-touch papers. If you touch it, you take it home with you. Please don't leave it behind if you've touched it. Again, it's just these reminders for us. And so all the other details, all the other notices are either in the parish newsletter or in the bulletin. You can also find the bulletin on the parish website as well. Let's stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God protect you from all harm and bless you with every good gift. Amen.
Amen.
May God fix your hearts on the words of eternal life and lead you to joy everlasting. Amen. Amen. May God grant you knowledge of what is right and good, that you may walk in the way of the commandments and become heirs with the saints in the heavenly city. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Colors of day dawn into the